Hip-hop, as we know, is on record as starting in the Bronx. From Coke LaRock, who is often acknowledged as the first rapper rocking parties in the 70s, to the rappers that came up after him that started to actually make records. It's not often disputed as to the origin, but which borough is the best at it is a pretty common question. What happens when you have an issue with a rapper from another borough? Well, in this instance, we have one of the first rap beefs ever. This is KRS-One and Boogie Down Productions versus MC Shan and the Juice Crew, aka the Bridge Wars. The beef took root in 1986 when BDP brought one of their first records to Mr. Magic but were rejected. Mr. Magic at the time was the main DJ who played hip-hop on the radio and was essentially behind the foundation of the Juice Crew, a collection of rappers mainly from Queensbridge. KRS-One took offense apparently to being rejected by Mr. Magic, and when listening to the classic MC Shan song, The Bridge, produced by Marty Marl, he took offense to them claiming that hip-hop started in Queensbridge. However, MC Shan and Marley insist that hip-hop itself is not what they were referring to, but rather the history of hip-hop in Queensbridge itself. Once again, it would seem like a matter of misunderstanding more than anything else. KRS-One then wrote the song South Bronx, which was a direct response to The Bridge, and was even made in the same style using a similar beat and cadence. Instead of The Bridge being repeated on the chorus, they used the South Bronx, the South South Bronx. On The Bridge, Shan talks about the rappers from Queensbridge. In return, KRS-One talks instead about rappers from the Bronx like Coke LaRock and Afrika Bambaataa. A line in particular that stands out though is, "So why don't you wise up, show all the people in the place that you are whack. Instead of trying to take out LL, you need to take your homeboys off the crack." That's because MC Shan had dissed LL Cool J on the B-side of Queensbridge for apparently copying one of their beats. With this taking place in 1986, this was around the same time that the beef with Kool Moe Dee and LL Cool J was starting as well, which I covered in a previous video on the channel. Now you could say that this isn't necessarily a diss, as it's really more so about his own neighborhood, but it definitely is a response to the track, and back then it was especially considered a big no-no to copy someone else's song. Copying, whether proven or not, is the start of many beefs in hip-hop. South Bronx would go on to be the lead single of BDP's debut album, Criminal Minded, released in March 1987. In August 1986, MC Shan released his debut studio album, Down by Law, which had the song The Bridge on it as well as Kill That Noise, the response track to South Bronx. This song samples I Get Lifted from the Sunshine Band, which is another popular song sampled in hip-hop. He doesn't name any names here, except in the outro where he mentions KRS-One and Scott LaRock, but he makes it quite clear that this is indeed a response to South Bronx. After the second verse, the chorus from South Bronx starts to play, and MC Shan interrupts with, "Kill that noise." So it's like, South Bronx, kill that noise. Kill that noise, of course, being the title of the song, and an obvious diss to BDP's South Bronx. On their debut album, Criminal Minded, BDP would respond again to MC Shan and the Juice Crew with the classic diss track, The Bridge Is Over. This song is considered by some to be the best diss track of all time, and personally I have it as a top 10 diss track. The beat is iconic and was also sampled for MC Ren's debut solo single, Final Frontier, which is one of my favorite songs by him. Plenty of other hip-hop songs would sample various parts of the song also. From the very beginning, the bridge is over chant is quite catchy and a direct response to MC Shan and the Juice Crew. KRS-One delivers a very direct verbal lashing, clearly attempting to put this beef to rest and claim victory, which to many he did just that. He attacks not only Shan and Marley, but also Mr. Magic and Roxanne Shante as well. Roxanne, years later in an interview, would say that KRS-One dissed them because they wanted to be part of the Juice Crew originally, but were denied. Dissing Mr. Magic might make sense as he's the one who rejected their song, but the whole crew often gets dissed in these situations. Perhaps the most famous lines from this song, however, are at the end of the first verse. Manhattan keeps on making it, Brooklyn keeps on taking it, Bronx keeps on making it, and Queens keeps on faking it. Now for those that don't know New York, money making Manhattan is a thing. Brooklyn is the home of stick-up kids. Bronx is known for being the birthplace of hip-hop. And he just disses Queens, as that's the home of Juice Crew, of course. It's a great line, easily one of my favorites, and would go on to be sampled in other songs in hip-hop as well. The song as a whole really solidified the idea that BDP won the beef. Unfortunately, weeks after the release of the album, DJ Scott LaRock would be shot and killed during a dispute in which he was helping D-Nice get out of an issue unrelated to the beef with the Juice Crew. Apparently, D-Nice had problems with some men because of a woman he was talking to, and turned to Scott LaRock for help. Very unfortunate, and once again, another beef or murder over a woman. a common occurrence in life in general. This occurred while they were working on their second album and would cause KRS-One to shift his focus away from the more violent lyrical content of their first album. The next diss tracks to come would be from other artists, some just choosing to insert themselves into the beef. One such diss was Beat You Down by Black Poet and DJ Rockwell Noel, artists also from Queens. On the track, they diss KRS-One for dissing Queens, and in one line even flips a line from The Bridge Is Over by stating, Manhattan keeps making it, Queens do the taxing. There's also threats of rioting to the Bronx with shotguns if they keep dissing Queens, as well as claiming that crack was created in the Bronx. I have no idea if crack really started in the Bronx, but it's an interesting idea. I've never really seen one city cited as being the origin of crack in particular. Overall, the track is pretty good, and it's one I never heard before doing the research for this video. Often, only the most popular of artists' diss tracks are covered in the media, so I enjoy finding out stuff like this and sharing it with others. Also released around this time was the Roxanne Shanté track, Have a Nice Day, produced by Marley Marl and written by Big Daddy Kane of the Juice Crew. The fourth verse in particular is where shots are sent towards BDP, with lines dissing KRS's name as well as claiming Scott LaRock copied his name from T LaRock. According to an interview by Big Daddy Kane, he and fellow Juice Crew member Biz Markie were both cool with KRS-One, hence the lack of disses between them, but he did write this song at the request of Roxanne. In October 1988, MC Shan released his second album, Born to be Wild, featuring the track Juice Crew Law, which had Shan going at KRS-One again in response to The Bridge Is Over. It's an alright song, but doesn't go as hard as the track it's responding to, however. After this, Shan wouldn't partake much more in the beef on Wax. Sometime after this, Philadelphia rapper Kool C would release the song Juice Crew Diss, which was also featured on his debut studio album, I Gotta Have It. Despite the title, the song is aimed mainly at MC Shan, and as you could probably guess, is a response to his song Juice Crew Law. Apparently, the reason for the diss is that MC Shan and other Juice Crew members had dealings with Philly record label Pop Art Records, but left for whatever reason. Kool C flips a bunch of lines from Juice Crew Law and other MC Shan songs like The Bridge, and disses him for switching record labels multiple times, claiming that he's been dropped, among other things. Oddly enough, Kool C actually sounds a bit like MC Shan on this track. Unfortunately, Kool C would some years later go on to be sentenced to life in prison for an attempted bank robbery that resulted in the death of a police officer. Another rapper named MC Mitchski, aka the rapping comedian, dissed the Juice Crew as well on a track named Brooklyn Blew Up the Bridge. On the track, he mainly sends shots at MC Shan for his appearance, dissing him for the way he dresses on stage. As his name implies, it's mainly a comedic diss. It's alright, not a top diss track in the beef or anything, really. Seemingly random diss tracks from others is probably why this whole situation is called The Bridge Wars. Another rapper, this one by the name of Butchy-B, jumped in and sent shots at KRS-One quite directly with the song Beatin' Down KRS-One. Apparently, Butchy-B dissed KRS because he's down with Mr. Magic, who KRS dissed on The Bridge Is Over. Throughout the whole song, he goes at KRS with an onslaught consisting of taking shots at him for his Jamaican accent he used on The Bridge Is Over, as well as multiple digs at his hairstyle, and disses D-Nice as well as cool DJ Red Alert, who was on the side of BDP. Perhaps the line that stands out the most here, for its shock value, however, is, "Just try to get with me and you'll be hanging out with Scott," as this was not too long after DJ Scott LaRock had been murdered. This is one of the first instances I can think of where a deceased member of a group was mentioned in order to diss somebody. This is a relatively common thing now in hip-hop, but back then, not at all. Butchy B also dissed him on the song Go Magic. As you could tell by the name, it's once again in support of DJ Mr. Magic. On this track, he mainly props up Mr. Magic and the radio station 107.5 WBLS. He shouts out the station like a dozen times. It kind of sounds like a commercial for a radio station, actually, which is kind of funny. It would be like me making a song dissing Domino's because I used to work at Pizza Hut. Anyways, the Bridge Wars continue. Remember Black Poet and DJ Rockwell Noel? They released another track going at KRS-One as well, titled Taking You Out. I wasn't able to find a full version of the song online anywhere, but did find a clip of it and the lyrics for the song. From what I was able to find, they once again went quite hard at KRS-One, cool DJ Red Alert, and D-Nice, as well as dissing KRS's wife at the time, Miss Melody. He dedicates multiple lines talking about her for being overweight, as well as sending shots to the rest for being skinny and weak. It sounds like an even harder diss than the previous one, and I'd like to give the full song a listen if I could find it somewhere. According to an interview of Black Poets, apparently an altercation between the two had occurred when BDP performed in Queens, and he approached them and offered to have a rap battle right there at the venue, but they declined unless they would be paid for it. The disses from Poet prompted KRS-One to respond on Wax with the song Still Number One, Numero Uno Re-Recording, another version of his song, I'm Still Number One, from the second BDP album, By All Means Necessary, released in May 1988. This would be the last of the full-on diss tracks back and forth among those involved for a while. There would still be references to the beef and shots thrown around for some time, however. In July 1990, on the song Black Men in Effect, from BDP's fourth album, Edutainment, KRS-One would dedicate a line in the song to literally say that he's not down with the Juice Crew. Pretty obvious given their beef, but lines like this let you know that it still hadn't been squashed yet, even though it might not be talked about as much. Around this time, Black Poet would form the duo PhD with DJ Hot Day. PhD meaning Poet and Hot Day. He would also go on to form the group Screwball a few years later, and on Screwball's debut album, Y2K, released in February 2000, Black Poet once again addressed the beef with BDP on You Love to Hear the Stories, which features MC Shan and is a reference to Shan's song, The Bridge. The song features samples of The Bridge and has Poet talking about rapping Queensbridge, including artists like Nas and Mobb Deep. On their second album, Loyalty, released in June 2001, Poet once again addressed the beef, this time on the track The Bio. As the title says, Poet gives his biography going back to 1987 when he first jumped into the beef between BDP and Juice Crew. He even mentions that he was ready for things to get violent. Like, this guy is truly down for Queensbridge. The dedication is nice to see, but I'm one of those that are glad that things didn't turn violent in this beef either. I enjoy storytelling tracks, and it may not be a diss, but it is giving us a perspective on how he felt at the time when things were at their height. Shortly before this track, the beef would be mentioned by Shan again on the track The Bridge 2001 from the QB's Finest compilation album released in November 2000. The song features a star-studded lineup of Queensbridge MCs Capone, Cormega, Mobb Deep, Nas, Millennium Thug, MC Shan, Nature, Tragedy Gaddafi, and Marley Marl. Marley does a new version of his intro from the original song, and MC Shan does the same with his verse, as well as making references to tracks like The Bridge Is Over. Things would be pretty quiet as far as the Bridge Wars would go for some years until in 2007 when KRS-One and Marley Marl released the collaboration album Hip Hop Lives, which is apparently a response to Nas's 8th album title, Hip Hop Is Dead, released the year prior. Who would have thought that these two longtime hip-hop rivals would release an album together? The song, The Victory, from the album features Black Poet. Once again, an unexpected pairing, but on the song they talk about the beef, with Poet on his verse stating how unbelievable people will find the collaboration and goes on to speak about putting the beef behind them. KRS would also do the same on his song as well as others on the album. For the most part, this would squash the beef amongst everyone except for KRS-One and MC Shan. Years later, in 2016, MC Shan would do a freestyle on the radio dissing KRS-One directly, and shortly afterwards, KRS-One responded with the track Still Hugging a Nut, S-H-A-N, which of course was aimed right back at Shan. On the track, KRS takes multiple shots at Shan that are pretty hard, but one of the lines that stands out most is, You done. The only way you gonna win this battle is if you bite my name and call yourself Shan One. It's funny, but this is the first diss track that KRS sent at Shan in years, but it's also one of the hardest, and at only 2 minutes long, contains multiple quotables, and is probably one of my favorites lyrically. Shan responded to that track with Revenge of the Walking Dead. This would lead to KRS-One coming back with the song Take 'Em Out, and once again coming hard at Shan. As far as I know, this would be the last track released between the two artists, and I find it funny that almost 30 years since The Bridge Is Over, the beef would be reignited, even though KRS at this point has made peace with the rest of the people associated with the beef. Outside of the tracks I mentioned, there would be a few others with slight jabs at artists involved in the beef, as well as various mentions in interviews. This is easily one of the longest beefs in hip-hop history, and is overall a good thing for hip-hop considering all of the diss tracks we've gotten, and the fact that this has managed to stay on wax and not escalated to physical violence. KRS-One and MC Shan have both admitted at some point that without this beef, KRS would not have had the career that he's had in hip-hop, and that it's not serious enough to resort to violence. Overall, the wide majority consider KRS-One to be the winner of the beef. He's had the most consistent career in hip-hop out of any of the artists involved, and is highly respected as a rapper and influential member of the hip-hop community, who went on to release numerous albums and be in multiple films and documentaries regarding hip-hop. MC Shan released a few albums as well, but was much less active in releasing music. Many attribute this to the beef, but only Shan can say with certainty. Without this beef, however, we wouldn't have KRS-One having the career that he's had, so I guess you could say hip-hop is the real winner here. What do you think about the so-called Bridge Wars? What beef would you like me to cover next? Leave a comment in the section below and let me know some of your favorite diss tracks. And as always, thanks for watching, remember to click that button to subscribe, and stay tuned for more.